As we know, social media can certainly motivate people for good and otherwise. Calls to action to clean up the oceans, rivers, and beaches have galvanized volunteers and gone viral. But given the magnitude of the problem, how should we assess the impact? Paul Solomon looks at one YouTube-focused campaign that has hit a particular chord. It's part of our continuing coverage of the global plastics problem.
We're almost done, Jimmy.
I know. Four straight days of picking up trash.
Two YouTube superstars scouring the Dominican Republic for trash.
This will take forever.
Jimmy Donaldson, aka Mr. Beast, known to his 99 million followers for pranks and giveaways.
See those two briefcases over there? There's $20,000 in them. If you go retrieve it, I'll let you keep the money.
This is a bird feeder, and everything you see surrounding me in my yard is an attempt to protect it from four thieving squirrels.
And former NASA engineer Mark Rober, with a mere 22 million YouTube fans, whose passion for engineering led to such science stunts as the squirrel run and do-it-yourself glitter bombs to deter package thieves. In 2019, Rober and Mr. Beast launched TeamSeas. Donate a dollar to plant a tree. 17 million planted thus far. And now, another internet campaign to combat climate change.
Which is why we're following up TeamSeas with TeamSeas.
And we need your help to get 30 million pounds of plastic and trash out of the friggin' ocean.
From rivers in far-flung countries to the shores of Easter Island, 2,000 miles offshore, rubbish rules the waves.
For every $1 you guys donate like this, one less pound of trash will be in the ocean.
To spare the ocean and those who inhabit it, besieged even by plastic straws.
Oh man.
TeamSeas raised $30 million in 2 months.
The median donation is like $5. That is bake sale money. That's lemonade stand money. That's tooth fairy money.
Money and time that now goes in part to TeamSeas cleanups at places like LA's Dockweiler Beach.
I saw it on Twitter and decided to come out.
My kid, he knows about the YouTuber and everything he said, so he wanted to come and help.
So you're a Mark Rober fan?
Yeah. Yes, he is.
Thank you guys for coming out here.
Partnering with TeamSeas and getting half the $30 million is the Ocean Conservancy, which recruits volunteers like these to comb beaches worldwide. Many a darn sight dirtier than Dockweiler. Doesn't look like there's much of a problem, if you don't mind my saying.
We have to be careful the assumptions we make. If you get close to the surface, you start to see a lot of these small flecks of things that are microplastics.
Here we got some plastic wrap, resembles jellies and other type of food that is heavily ingested by sea turtles, fish.
Micro bits of plastics in the sand, oceans, and even our bodies, says Ocean Conservancy VP for Plastics, Nick Malos.
This plastic bag.
Every animal in the ocean, and humans being atop the food chain, are also ingesting them.
Environmental engineer Anya Brandon, among many scientists who thought there might be a partial fix to the plastics problem, tried mealworms, whose gut bacteria digest styrofoam. After years of research, she concluded it was no real fix at all.
It would take probably a couple thousand mealworms a month or two to eat something like a typical styrofoam coffee cup. And we've got a lot of cups out there in the world.
So Brandon left the lab to work for the Ocean Conservancy. The other half of TeamSeas' $30 million goes to the Ocean Cleanup, a Dutch nonprofit which makes interceptors. As an engineer, Mark Rober loves these garbage gobbling robots.
80% of the plastic flowing to the ocean from rivers comes from just 1% of the rivers. So their idea is to put these trash-eating robots on those worst offending rivers, and that will go a long way to fixing the problem at the source.
The Ocean Cleanup reports that to date, it has removed more than 3 million pounds of trash from the world's rivers and oceans.
Here in LA, you can see there the moorings that'll be built to anchor the device in place.
Kerjon Lee works for Los Angeles County, where the first U.S. interceptor is headed within months, just north of Dockweiler Beach. This placid canal floods during winter storms, funneling debris from streets and drains into the Pacific.
Every year, about 30 tons of waste, litter, bottles, food waste, floating trash into this water body here.
But wait, are these really solutions? There are only 8 interceptors worldwide, and this one will handle just 9 of the 600 miles of waterways in LA alone. And plastic is pouring into our oceans at a rate of 8 million metric tons, or more than 17 billion pounds each year. As for trash picking, how much beach gunk are volunteers likely to gather by hand?
TeamSeas is proposing to remove 13,600 tons of plastic over 2 years, I think it is. The amount of plastic that we add to the ocean means that that is added back to the ocean every 15 hours.
British atmospheric scientist Simon Clark.
Over time, the integrated difference that you have on the environment is going to be much less than if you'd primed your audience to think that systematic change is the way to fix this problem.
Clearly, this is a serious video.
Clark is also a YouTuber, though by contrast to Rober and Mr. Beast, his is a micro following, 430,000. But they follow his skepticism.
If I'm laying here in the ocean covered in plastic and somebody comes in to help clean some of it up, oh, thank you. By the way, could you do something about the people who are just adding the plastic in?
Simon could sit in his bathtub and criticize all day long. I'll be out here actually on the beach picking up trash, inspiring the next generation.
Well, his argument is that the only real solutions are big policy solutions.
That's right, he's right, but how do you get policy? You elect people who care about those issues. And if politicians know that people care about these issues and they see that $30 million was raised grassroots on my platform, you better believe I'm going to be talking about those policies that enforce that.
And on the beach, people were listening and spreading awareness.
If I see somebody else doing it, maybe I can help out too.
Even the people like around here, right, that are having their parties and doing their thing, they're seeing us clean up. That's creating all this awareness.
So we'll start a new bag because this one's probably getting kind of heavy.
Do you think when you grow up you'll be more aware now of trash in the ocean and on the beaches and stuff?
Yeah.
At the end of the day, 151 volunteers picked up 206 pounds of trash. With a little help from Mark Rober, less from me.
I got nothing in mind.
But hey, I started late. The motivations for the younger trash collectors? So did you pick up trash?
Yeah.
Why?
Because the earth can get polluted.
And for those who might be dawdling, Rober added an incentive, a selfie in exchange for a bucket.
Did you guys all pick up trash? Did you get a lot of big pieces?
Yes.
Okay, then you earned this.
You have to start somewhere, and it starts with the hearts. I'm in the business of getting the hearts and minds of the people caring about this thing. I think the policies will come from that.
Is this your first time picking up trash?
Yeah.
Was it fun?
Yeah.
Did you enjoy picking up trash?
Yes.
Well, he snared some hearts and minds here, and between him and buddy Mr. Beast, another 122 million, mostly young people, are getting the message. For the PBS NewsHour, Paul Salmon, combing Dockweiler Beach with only this story to show for it.